India is not the Taliban's Afghanistan or the Islamic State Syria, and neither does it desire to be. That is why when Padmavati controversy took a chilling, murderous turn today, with the fringe threatening to behead Bhansali and chop off the nose of Deepika Padukone, there is a sense of unease and disquiet. Listen to this unhinged but scary threat issued by the so-called self-styled guardians of history, of tradition, of legacy out there. Listen to their hate. Listen to their unhinged, perverse, and extremely venomous mindset. Listen to it.
हमें अगर बॉम्बे जाके बंसाली के घर में जाकर उसको घुसकर मारना पड़ा तो मारेंगे, और हम तो बहुत श्योर हैं मूवी हम रोक देंगे। राजस्थान में तो किसी भी कीमत पे नहीं लग रही। अगर हमें उसके लिए बंसाली का सिर भी काटना पड़ा तो काट देंगे। इसमें हमें कोई गुंजाइश ही नहीं है कि हम नहीं काटेंगे। मूवी लग रही है, कहीं नहीं लग रही मूवी। आप कह रहे हो तोड़ दिया, हम कह रहे तोड़ेंगे और फोड़ेंगे।
हजारों साल पहले श्री राम के भाई लक्ष्मण ने इसी तरह से एक आई थी महिला श्रीलंका की, और जो रावण की बहन थी, बार बार मना करने के बाद, बार बार चेतावनी देने के बाद वो नहीं मानी, उसका नाक काट के उसको ये सजा दी थी कि तेरी यही सजा है, तू महिला है, हम हाथ नहीं उठा सकते, पर तेरी यही सजा है, और ये सजा अगर तू लेना चाहती है दीपिका पादुकोण, तो सहर्ष राजपूत क्षत्रिय ये मजबूरन करेंगे।
मैं सरेआम ये घोषणा करता हूँ और जिम्मेदारी लेता हूँ कि अगर उन्होंने ये फिल्म वापस नहीं ली, संजय लीला भंसाली जी अगर ये अपनी फिल्म का प्रदर्शन पर रोक स्वयं नहीं इससे वापस लेते हैं, तो हम क्षत्रिय समाज उनकी जो भी कोई युवक या कोई क्षत्रिय समाज का कोई लड़का उनकी जो गर्दन काट के लेके आएगा, क्षत्रिय समाज उनकी गर्दन काटने वाले युवक को 5 करोड़ रुपए का इनाम देगा।
Will anyone who's God-fearing and faced with the prospect of losing his life would be rattled? Sanjay Leela Bhansali is rattled, and he has seemingly buckled under pressure. There is a mediatory effort that is going on, and he's also written to the CBFC seeking the early pre-screening of the film Padmavati. Bhansali says the pre-screening is for groups who are raising objections and that this pre-screening will quell rumors. So he is now under pressure, being forced to apply for the certificate for a film that is to release on the 1st of December. He is forced to perhaps even submit himself to the scrutiny and the censorious scissors of those who, for political reasons and political alone, viewers, political alone, have thrown in their lot with this rabid fringe group. It shouldn't have come to this. If anyone, it should have been the Karni Sena, the fringe group, and others like the Rajput Sena that should be fearing the consequences. This is because the threats they have issued could lead to their arrest. Will the state apply the law? First, the threat was that Karni Sena members will enter Bhansali's house and beat him up, a clear case of violation under Section 503 of the IPC. Then they said, if need be, Karni Sena members will behead Bhansali. Criminal intimidation is punishable with imprisonment under Section 506 of the IPC. Not content, the focus then shifted to Deepika Padukone. Karni Sena members, in full public view, in a press briefing, they said they will chop Deepika Padukone's nose off as punishment, the same punishment that Lord Lakshman inflicted on Shurpakna. A violation under 504 of the IPC. And now a so-called Thakur leader has emerged, putting a bounty of 5 crore rupees on Bhansali's head. This man can be charged under Section 505 of the IPC. But will the state apply the law? No. No movement as of now. The Senas, all these Senas, the Karni Senas, the Rajput Senas, the several others who are out there, should be doubly punished because their opposition it appears, is not driven entirely by conviction, but perhaps by opportunism and political compulsion. Here's evidence caught on Times Now camera. These hotheads who will behead in the name of history don't even know their history. Listen to the member of the Rajput Sena who doesn't even know who Alauddin Khilji is. And they say that this man has in fact besmirched the reputation of Rani Padmavati. They don't know who this person is. We confronted some of these misdirected thugs in disguise today as legatees of Rajput pride and dignity. Listen to this. It'll shock you.
So what is the history? Padmavati history?
Then, as a press reporter, don't you think you should have read and come?
I know. You tell me. I know what history is. I want to know what your history is. The history that you
see. Our convention is very simple. That, like last film, Bajirao Mastani.
No, Bajirao Mastani.
1 minute. Let me come to our convention.
Yeah, I'm talking about
I don't want to talk about the history here. Why should we talk about the history?
Bajirao
Mastani, they have shown that Mastani and his wife dancing together, having an item number, was not in the history. No. Because of that last film.
Bajirao.
Yes, they are affected. He has to apologize to them. Okay, fine. Dream sequence. In dream sequence, if you are showing the film of this guy, what was the other thing there? In Bajirao, in this new film, I forgot the name.
Khilji
is having such a dream. Why?
That's what I'm asking.
Well, joining us is Vaibhav Agarwal, spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party from Rajasthan, Raj Purohit, BJP MLA, here in Mumbai. Also with us, Vikram Pratap Singh, low-end spokesperson of the Rajput Karni Sena that has gone out today and issued this threat to behead. Suhail Seth, a columnist, Sanjay Pinto, a lawyer, KTS Tosi, MP and former ASG. Now, I want to begin straight off by asking you, Mr. Vaibhav Agarwal, and Raj Purohit, perhaps Mr. Purohit first. Mr. Purohit, has the silence of your government at the center and of your party only emboldened the fringe that now threatens murderous violence? And will you be responsible if any of these individuals actually go out there to behead and physically harm both the actor and the director?
Basically, Sanjay Bansali has done a such great thing, and he has hurt the sentiment of an important community of India and brave community of like Rajput. He should have not done it. When the agreement took place in Jaipur,
I don't think you heard my question, Mr. Purohit.
The Rajputs and the
I don't think you heard my question. Will you arrest these people?
Pardon?
Would you arrest these people?
What is that question?
Would you arrest these individuals? Would you arrest?
Who I am to arrest?
These various Kranti Senas, Karni Senas, Rajput Senas, Thakurs, self-styled guardians of our history. Will you arrest them?
Bansali should be arrested. Bansali should be arrested.
I'm asking you.
No.
Will you arrest them?
Yes. Why not Bansali should be arrested?
There you go.
Yes. Hello. Why should Bansali should not be arrested?
Sir, you are a Bharatiya Janata Party lawmaker. You don't belong, sir, to the Taliban.
It is a matter of sentiment.
For God's sake.
It is a matter of sentiment, sir.
That doesn't mean that you can go there and behead somebody and issue threats such as these.
You should also respect the sentiment, no? That you should. Now, why you are hurting the
tomorrow Kashmiri terrorists, stone pelters will get up and say that we will burn the national flag. Will you not act against them? We will behead your jawans. Will you not act against them? They will say we are saying it out of our sentiments. They are saying that our Kashmiri sentiments dictate this.
Bunding national flag is just is equal to is
my dear man, my dear man,
sentiment.
I am saying you are setting a very bad precedent. There is a very bad precedent being set. Let me, maybe you don't, maybe you're not educated enough. And I'll be very, I'll be extremely, no, excuse me, sir.
How it can be a precedent?
I will be extremely, I will be extremely rude tonight.
Those who have failed to respect their history,
now they will understand. No, I will be extremely rude tonight. I will be extremely rude tonight.
How important and sensitive this issue is.
1 second. Don't twirl your mustaches up and sit there. I'll be extremely rude tonight. I'm asking you some basic questions. So please listen to them. And the basic question I'm asking is, when someone says we will enter Bhansali's house and beat him up, the section of the law kicks in, section 503. We will behead Bhansali, section 506, criminal intimidation. These people are not saying it under some blanket. They're saying it actually in public. You should pick them up and arrest them. Then you can deal with Mr. Bhansali. But first, when people are publicly breaking the law, when they have said what they've said, which constitutes a criminal offense, you must act. So I'm asking you, sir, once again, Vaibhav Agarwal, Vaibhav Agarwal, on the soil of Rajasthan.
Yes.
Criminal intimidation, punishable by imprisonment, right. And section 503, threatening injury to another person. People are breaking the law. What are you doing about it?
Right. People are breaking the law, but the people who are responsible for breaking the law, they are versus an individual entity. The individual entity has to come out in full force of the law. The Indian Constitution asks them to come and report the law, and the government will act. There is a process of law. Where is the problem?
The force,
I don't
the force that you are talking about,
we should take
Vaibhav Agarwal, the force that you are talking about,
Rahul,
the force that you are talking about is being threatened by, is being threatened by, is being threatened with beheadings.
I am not supporting the violence at all.
Well, you are.
I am not supporting the violence.
You can take Suomo to action under the law. There are enough lawyers, and that's why we have lawyers on this panel. There's Sanjay Pinto, and there's Mr. KTS Tulsi. And let me not even talk about the double standards of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Excuse me. Just hold your thoughts. I want to bring in Suhail Seth here. 1 minute.
No, there are no double standards of the Bharatiya Janata Party.
No, I'll tell you what the double standards are. We'll get to it. Now, just wait a minute.
Which is very clear.
Now, pipe down.
What about
Mr. Agarwal, pipe down.
What about they beheading our history?
1 second.
What about they making
gentlemen, please. Let's speak. Let's not speak over each other, please.
Why nobody asked Bhansali?
Okay, 1 second. One second. Mr. Pinto, 1 second. Mr. Suhail Seth, you have a state that says we are waiting for a complaint to be filed.
My belief, Rahul, is the following. When I last checked, the Rajputs were amongst the bravest community India's ever known, always admired and constantly respected. It doesn't behove of a Rajput to say I will behead someone because there is a disagreement over a creative interpretation of history. Number two, the government must take Suomoto action against people who behave like terrorists saying we will behead someone. This is not the way a civilized society behaves.
Perhaps against people
on
who are
the one
inciting
hand, you have
violence.
Narendra Modi, who is going across the world. Did I interrupt you? So just keep quiet and listen. I did not interrupt you. Have the decency to listen.
Act like, no.
Okay, I don't belong to any political dispensation.
You are,
have
you are
the decency and just shut up.
Vaibhav Agarwal.
Time and
Vaibhav Agarwal.
On the subject knowledge.
Vaibhav Agarwal. Look, don't sit here and disrupt this debate.
Vaibhav Agarwal.
I think you're mixing up the platform and you're mixing up the channel. Now, if you have a problem, go shout somewhere else.
Very civil with him.
Give us a chance. At least give us a chance to speak.
We'll give you all a chance to speak. I'm going one by one.
Let me continue. Mute this chap. He's not even making sense.
1 minute.
Let me
wait your turn.
The state must take Suomoto action against anyone. Forget this film. Number three, when I last checked, in our country, we have the rule of democracy and therefore the rule of law. There's a certification body. There is a body that allows for films to be screened. More importantly, there are courts of law. if either of us, any of us, and we are all entitled to protest, we are all entitled to have disagreements, but we mustn't be disagreeable. If we have a disagreement, my advice would be we must follow the due process of law. I think Mr. Agarwal or Mr. Purohit said about the law in our country. My point is, it does not do the Prime Minister any justice. It doesn't do the Bharatiya Janata Party any justice. The party is building itself on a plank of development, on a plank of inviting people to India, of telling the world that India is ready for business.
Yes.
India is ready for growth. We're encouraging entrepreneurs to come and start up India. And on the one hand, we have this amazing India story. And then on the other, we are showing ourselves to be barbarians at the gate.
Yes.
We are showing ourselves to be intolerant. We are showing ourselves to be dismissive about creative license. My theory is, and look, I have the greatest respect and the highest regard for the Rajput community, as I said before, for every community in our country. Every community has the right to protest, has the right to be heard, has the right for their story to be told ethically, transparently, honestly. If you disagree, there is a process. Follow a due process. We are not living in barbaric times.
Precisely.
Where we will send
That's the point.
You, we will go to your house. You can't put bounties of 5 crores on people's heads.
No one
That's
wants.
My limited point.
No one
I have
wants.
No disagreement with the Rajput community protesting.
Let's be very
my
clear.
My worry is about the manner of protest.
Vaibhav Agarwal, let's be very clear.
Always
okay,
disagree,
we've heard you out.
Don't be disagreeable. Said. That's my limited point.
Yeah, I think that
Can
point has been expansively made. Well, 1 second, gentlemen. I
Can
want
I
to
counter?
Open this out. I want to open this out to everyone. Now, don't get ants in your pants. Rajput Karni Sena member Vikram Pratap Singh, relax. Give me 30 seconds, I'll come to you. You don't want to behead Suhail Seth. Relax. We are coming out to you. Relax,
you
calm
should.
Down. Okay, now, Vaibhav Agarwal, the problem
Actually,
is...
behead me, given the smog, okay. My head is already swirling.
Okay, well, hang on. I want to ask you, Vaibhav Agarwal, you've heard Suhail Seth out. No one here is even remotely suggesting that any community's
yes,
rights... any community's history should be violated. No one is suggesting that. All we're suggesting is wait for the filmmaker to approach the CBFC. Wait for the filmmaker and the CBFC to finish with that due process. If the CBFC recommends various cuts, we will have to wait for what Sanjay Leela Bhansali has to say. He might agree, he may choose to disagree. There's a court of law. There's a process to be followed. But when you give individuals like the Karni Sena, and I know the politics behind this, I know you've just had a rapprochement with the Rajput community which felt alienated. I understand that. But when you give them the veto power, you are opening the country out to all sorts of fringe elements. Tomorrow the PFI will jump in. Day after the sympathizers of Pakistani terror groups will jump in.
Absolutely.
Day after, people from the extreme east of this country that are batting for China, certain terror groups will start expressing a particular view. You will open the floodgates. So I'm asking you, sir, the best way to deal with this situation is to lock up some of these people. Now I'm asking you, why can't your government take Suomoto action?
Sure. Sure. I think it's a very pertinent question, and I would be happy to address that. But before that, I'd just like to address a little something that my Kabil dost in a filmy manner said, that we are trying to display to the rest of the world that we are showing ourselves as barbarians. You know, I don't think Suhail Seth knows the history, and he's done his homework before coming on to the debate. You know, I would like to tell you that Alauddin Khilji was the first one against the Indian community. He imposed 4 taxes against non-Muslim community in India during his rule. Do I need to say more?
Yes.
Weber, you know? Are you making
so
this about Hindus and Muslims?
I don't even want to talk
no,
about it.
No, are you making this about Hindus and Muslims?
Is,
because
is,
let me jog your
minute,
memory to a
minute,
certain
one
number
minute,
of
one minute,
Hindu
don't
kings,
be a joker jumping
Hindu
in the
emperors.
Debate.
No,
one
wait a minute.
One minute.
No, Weber, look.
It's not about
Weber Hindu Agarwal,
Muslims,
let's not make this about minute. Hindus and Muslims. Don't denigrate our sense of tradition and history. And
no,
also
I'm not,
our secularism.
I'm just
I know that your...
No,
one second. I know that your saffron credentials prevents you from taking a position tonight. I sympathize with you. But don't let situations go to the point where every Joe Block terror organization in this country invokes sentiment and kills people and says, hang on, we did it to preserve some of our ideology, our traditions, our culture. There are enough mad loonies out there. So don't open the floodgates for the loonies. And I'm asking you, Mr. Vaibhav Agarwal, you seem to be an educated man. So you're a spokesperson of India's ruling national party. I expect you to rise to the occasion and say, yes, Karni Sena member one, Karni Sena number two should go to jail. Why don't you bring yourself...
The same sense of maturity we demand from Bollywood industry.
Why don't you come clean and say, yes, that should happen?
We already arrested 8 people for the Kota incident. And yes, Rahul, we agree to that. And there is no problem. The ministry, the Home Minister of Rajasthan State, Shri Gulab Chand Kataria, and Vasundhara Ji's leadership has already made it clear that we're in the process of reviewing the entire situation by the Ministry of Culture. And then the Home Ministry has its monitoring department already monitoring the situation.
Mr.
8 people have already arrested.
Mr. Agarwal.
There are other instances that are there, but there has to be a cause of action.
Mr. Agarwal, let me bring in some of the legal luminaries and talk about cause of action. Is there no cause of action, Mr. Tulsi? Is there no cause of action? Are we going to still hunt for it?
No. On 14th November, in Kota, the activists of Karni Sena have vandalized a cinema hall. That's writing a cognizable offense has already been committed. Apart from the threats of murder and offering reward, that's incitement to violence, incitement to kill. All these are cognizable offenses. The police does not require. No question of suo motu, the police must go and arrest them. It's their lawful obligation. The police should register a case with regard to vandalizing the cinema hall if they have not already registered. And then they should be taken into custody before the fire engulfs the entire state or the rest or many other parts of the country also. This must be nipped in the bud. It's the obligation of the state. The first obligation of the state is to protect life and property of its citizens. If they cannot do this, they have no right to stay in office. Such a government must be sent packing.
There you go.
8 people have already been arrested for the
Vaibhav Agarwal, why don't you arrest the bosses of the Karni Sena today who issued the threat? In case you didn't hear it, I'll play them out.
We've already arrested 8
people. Let's play
them
out. Maybe he didn't hear. Let's give him an opportunity to react to these. Let's play it out. Yeah, listen.
हमें अगर बॉम्बे जाके बंसाली के घर में जाकर उसको घुसकर मारना पड़ा तो मारेंगे और हम तो बहुत श्योर हैं मूवी हम रोक देंगे. राजस्थान में तो किसी भी कीमत पे नहीं लग रही. अगर हमें उसके लिए बंसाली का सिर भी काटना पड़ा तो काट देंगे. इसमें हमें कोई गुंजाइश ही नहीं है कि हम नहीं काटेंगे. मूवी लग रही है कहीं नहीं लग रही मूवी. आप फिर वो तोड़ दिया हम गया तोड़ेंगे और फोड़ेंगे.
हजारों साल पहले श्री राम के भाई लक्ष्मण ने इसी तरह से एक आई थी महिला श्रीलंका की और जो रावण की बहन थी बार बार मना करने के बाद बार बार चेतावनी देने के बाद वो नहीं मानी. उसका नाक काट के उसको ये सजा दी थी कि तेरी यही सजा है. तू महिला है हम हाथ नहीं उठा सकते पर तेरी यही सजा है. और ये सजा अगर तू लेना चाहती है दीपिका पादुकोण तो सहर्ष राजपूत क्षत्रिय ये मजबूरन करेंगे.
मैं सरेआम ये घोषणा करता हूँ और जिम्मेदारी लेता हूँ कि अगर उन्होंने ये फिल्म वापस नहीं ली संजय लीला भंसाली जी अगर ये अपनी फिल्म के प्रदर्शन पर रोक स्वयं नहीं इससे वापस लेते हैं तो हम क्षत्रिय समाज उनकी जो भी कोई युवक या कोई क्षत्रिय समाज का कोई लड़का उनकी जो गर्दन काट के लेके आएगा क्षत्रिय समाज उनकी गर्दन काटने वाले युवक को 5 करोड़ रुपए का इनाम देगा.
नाउ महिपाल मकराना लीडर Vaibhav Agarwal made this threat. Will you arrest him tomorrow or tonight? Will you arrest him? Yes, no.
I heard that. This is absolutely ludicrous, and I do not appreciate what Mahipal ji has said, and other members of
will you
of
arrest
the
him?
Sena has said there is a way to express feelings. I absolutely understand that.
But the question is,
will you arrest him?
Whether he will be arrested or not.
You are making
However,
movies like Sexy
I would like
Durga.
To say,
what is this?
Will you arrest
one
him?
Minute,
where
one
is
minute.
This dem-
will you arrest him?
Going?
I'm but asking you, will you arrest him?
An offence in law, an offence not committed is not an offence.
Give an answer.
It is not my parole.
You can act suo moto.
Ask a question. Why don't
you can act suo moto. 1 minute. 1 minute, Mr. One second. 1 minute, Mr. Vikram Pratap Singh. I'm coming out to you. I'm going to question you too. No thuggery is going to be allowed on this show. Wait a minute. I'm asking you, Mr. Vaibhav Agarwal, I'm asking you a specific question. Will your government take suo moto action?
Yes.
And that action can be taken by the state HRC, issue a notice to these individuals. They can file an FIR. Several things can happen. I'm asking you, will you arrest them? Yes, no. Answer me.
But, you know, I want
don't
to understand.
Go, but,
I want to understand. I'll answer that question. I know yes and no answers don't work here.
Oh, really?
No, it's not my
oh, really?
If
a murder is going to take
no,
place and yes and no answers are not going to work.
However, I
what is
like
your compulsion? What is the compulsion that is holding the Bharatiya Janata Party back
well,
from acting
you know,
like a responsible party in government? I'm asking you. You can't guarantee citizens their safety. What are you
Rahul,
doing in power?
Rahul,
you tell
government,
me. You tell me. You think it's odious? You think
I
it's
agree.
Not good for them to,
what you're saying.
Issue threats?
I agree to what you're
if you
saying,
can't guarantee anyone their safety, what are you doing in power?
I denounce the violent actions. No, people's safety is guaranteed.
Really?
There is no problem.
The same gentleman, Mr. Sanjay Leela Bhansali, in your state was beaten up, roughed up on TV. We'll pull out those pictures. We will pull out those pictures.
Already been addressed. Now you understand.
No, no, no. Don't give me. No, no. Don't give me this. No, don't give me this spin.
No,
don't give me this. Look at those pictures, January 27, 2017.
Rahul,
Mr. Vaibhav Agarwal, look at your screen.
10 seconds.
Look at your screen. Those are the pictures of a physical assault on Sanjay Leela Bhansali by the precise characters we are today addressing. And I'm asking you, sir, if you can't guarantee the safety
why
of citizens,
Sanjay Leela
quit.
Sanjay Leela Bhansali, and I know him personally.
Great.
Why,
good
why
for you.
He has a battery of lawyers. Why hasn't he sued the guys who've done it?
You are abdicating responsibility.
You
is the state of Rajasthan, the powerful state of Rajputs and of warrior
However,
people. No, excuse me.
Aapne
chuniya pehen rakhi hai, sir. Have you worn bangles today? Have you worn bangles? The great Rajput tradition is being completely decimated by a bunch of hooligans. And the state of Rajasthan, led by Vaibhav Agarwal and company, have no answer to give on national television. It is shocking. It is completely shocking. Where are we going? And we have to ask ourselves.
We have answer. Let us allow, please.
Swift State wants to come in on this.
Yes, I want to know where.
This is Rajput courage.
You know, where are we going?
I just want to say,
versus the rest of
let us
please, let us count up, please.
This has now become. This has now become the descriptor.
I think that's
this has now
shocking.
Become the descriptor of Indian political discourse. If the spokesperson of a ruling party in a state as rich, as culturally evolved as Rajasthan, cannot on a television program denounce violence, not violence, and for that matter say that his government will arrest people, as Mr. Tulsi very rightly said, who have threatened to incite.
And I've been,
will
I've
you
been
again
on this debate
keep
for last
quiet and listen?
One week,
you must
and
learn
I have
to listen.
These
you're the spokesperson, not an interrupter.
Again.
Listen.
You know, you
learn to listen.
Around
Vasundhara Raja Sindhya should first sack him because he's doing no good to her as spokesperson.
No, I'm listening. I'm
so
listening
I have a
lot.
Really simple
I think
feeling.
The
BJP needs to review people like him who
so
should either
so
not come on television or when they come on television should speak intelligently. If they want to speak like intellectual innocence, they should do that at home. It is a
of
travesty that the BJP is represented by this man
from you, Suhail,
who can't take a stand and is
you
now
know,
blaming Sanjay Leela Bhansali for the woes that will befall him by a so-called threat of a beheading.
This is the same political party. No, wait a minute. Vaibhav Agarwal, now listen to me. You know, your silence is going to come back and haunt you. It's going to come back and haunt you because your party, the BJP. Yeah, listen
so
to me.
Below malignment levels.
Okay, one second. Listen to me. The same party, the Bharatiya Janata Party, attacks, and I'm underlining the word, the left government in Kerala for doing nothing when its own cadre are butchered. They're first threatened, much like the Karni Sena is threatening Bhansali and company, and then they are butchered, and the left government does nothing, and the BJP sits on this show night after night and ridicules the left for doing nothing and calling them people who have no conviction and no courage. You are today doing exactly the same that the left is doing, and therefore, sir, tomorrow you lose the moral authority to question anyone else. And that's why I'm telling you, it's in your own good. It's for your own good if you act.
Constitutional political party. Rahul, it's very simple. Karni Sena has nothing to do with politics. Karni Sena is a community, it's an NGO.
Do you as the ruling party denounce this?
Karni Sena and Sanjay Leela Bhansali are the producers of the movie.
Okay.
It is, the state has nothing to do with it. We denounce their actions completely, which are violent and not right faith. However, we've denounced left as well. Night after night, because they are constitutionally formed a
political
party.
They are doing exactly what you do. They say that those that are creating the mayhem in their state are also NGOs. Excuse me.
Party.
They are.
Left,
1 minute. Vaibhav Agarwal, I don't think you have the sweep.
Taking moral obligation.
I don't think you have the sweep. No, no, 1 second. You have the sweep of facts to actually comment on certain issues. You're way out of your depth here. Your Bharatiya Janata Party, the party you belong to, criticizes the left government for doing nothing. Nothing in Kerala. And they say, the left says, we can't help it. These are NGOs.
Absolutely.
These are
Why
NGOs.
Why is the government doing anything?
So you're doing exactly what the left does. You're doing exactly what the left does. And this is shocking. It is absolutely shocking you're justifying violence. Now let me deal with the thug on the show. 1 minute. Let me now let me deal with the thugs on the show.
Any Rajput, there are no murders by Karni.
Let me deal with the thugs on the show now.
Two cases be similar.
1 minute. Let me deal with the
absolutely not.
No, no, 1 second. Let me deal with the Rajput Karni Sena that is today becoming a malevolent force in the state. And it has been given the freedom to become one. And I want to come to you now. Vikram Pratap Singh, what gives you the right to behead someone or to chop off someone's nose?
Yes.
What gives you the right? Who's given you this right?
Will you hear my answer? Can I answer?
With bated breath, I want to hear your answer.
Yes. First of all, Whatever this is happening, what fuss is all about, why it is one-sided, let us speak. If you want to know history, I'll let you know history. If you want to talk about law, we will also talk about law. That same law gives us a right to express, but don't give us a right to repress or regress. As a nation, we are regressing. Today we are saying, because if we are not able to preserve our culture and history, then what you will tell to your coming generation? Ki we have let us allow to make movie on sexy Durga. Is this right to constitution, right to freedom of expression? Where you are giving, what giving example you people are doing? Give us a chance. If you respect that food, gives us a chance to speak. To speak on public platform. If you want to ask history from us, then ask us. 3 times self-immolation has done. 16,000 Ranis have gone for self-immolation. What about that sensitivity? Why don't you Bollywood people be sensitive, diligent about such issues? This is the question. This is the question. Answer, Mr. Sohail Seth. Why you are keep quiet now? Why you are keeping quiet? Beheading, it's just a reaction.
Vikram Pratap Singh.
We have started from a
Vikram Pratap Singh. Vikram Pratap Singh.
Making movie without taking permission. Without
so you're saying you're so hurt.
And then we gone there for talking.
Vikram Pratap Singh. Vikram Pratap Singh is saying he's so hurt.
Yes.
He is so besides himself that these are all spontaneous outbursts of anger. This is the justification. Okay, now let me tell you a few things, Vikram Pratap Singh. You talked about a movie called Sexy Durga. Do you know that the movie is no longer called Sexy Durga? It's called S Durga.
Yes.
You know why? Do you know why?
I know. Yeah.
Why?
I know. But,
why?
But what
no, no, why?
Is showing, what Facebook is
tell
showing,
me, sir,
what print media,
why?
Everything, everywhere it is.
Tell me
that.
Why.
What are,
tell
what
me
are,
why. Arre, ruk jao, bhai. Vikram Pratap Singh, relax. You asked me a few questions, I'm answering you. The reason why Sexy Durga has become S Durga is because there's a process.
Okay.
And the process is called the CBFC. And the CBFC has stepped in and said we cannot have a provocative slogan or a title of a film such as this. The law of the land kicked in. The law of the land took care of people's sentiment. Okay? You are not, sir, the law of the land. You might want to become the law of the land. Wait a minute.
CFC proves that
Mr. Karni Sena, sir.
It is not absolute.
Vikram Pratap Singh.
It is not absolute.
That wait a minute.
Establishment of CBFC
let
says
let
that
the
right
CB.
To,
1 minute.
Yeah.
Why do you want to keep shouting, sir?
Okay,
what are you
okay,
getting
okay,
out of shouting? Aapne bahut cheek liya hai. You've already shouted a great deal. All day today, your leaders have been shouting. 5 days, your leaders have been shouting. No one is here to upset your sentiments.
No one is here to upset
the sense of history that the Rajputs actually hold on to dearly, and they have all their right to do so, and it must be preserved. But, sir, the observation that is being made is that the Karni Sena is crossing the lines of civilized discourse. It is going out there and threatening to behead people. That is not acceptable. In a culture, in
our
a tradition,
question,
in a Hindu spirituality, which is very peaceful. Because if you become like those you despise, like the Khiljis of the world, like the invaders who came in, like the Taliban, like all their descendants, you will have a problem. Because then you will become like them and your history will get desecrated. That is the point. Don't become like the people you are agitating against. Why do you want to become like that? You answer me that question.
Can I answer?
Yes.
Can I come in, please?
I'll bring you in, Mr. Pinto, right after this.
Can I answer?
Go ahead.
Rahul, you talk about CBFC. That very CBFC in 2016, ministry under the chairmanship of Mr. Shyam Benegal, who is director, belongs to Bollywood community. Under his chairmanship, a committee was established on the rights and all this stuff, what CBFC do and what CBFC not do, its jurisdiction, its scope. And in this very recommendation, what they are saying, the CBFC is not for moral policing. Is not for moral policing. The very word says, if it is not for moral policing, then what is the meaning of having such bodies in India?
Vikram Prasad Singh, what are you saying?
And I'm saying, if it is sensitive matter, then why are you approaching and taking certificate from that same institute?
I am bewildered. I don't know. Maybe you're using words which you don't quite comprehend. But let me bring in Mr.
Pinto. Then issue Primo.
He wants moral guardians. He wants a moral police. He doesn't want the CBFC.
Let others speak. This is only a reflection of your intolerance. Can you let others speak, please? Yeah. See, I for one believe that, the censor board needs to use scissors, but you have in our country a strange situation where somebody who likes a Facebook post is arrested, but self-styled centers spring up there and they use a sledgehammer and it's shocking. There's a phrase, don't cut your nose to spite your face. Today you have self-styled groups like this who will threaten to cut people's noses just to show their face for publicity. That is what it at least comes across as. Now the gentleman there spoke about the CBFC guidelines. The CBFC, what is clause one of those guidelines that he's quoting say? It says, you shall not unduly curb artistic freedom or creative expression, that you will judge things according to the current contemporary standards, that any regressive thinking is banned. These are, of course, there is freedom of speech and expression. Yes, there is also the CBFC draws its power from the Cinematograph Act, Section 5B, very clearly talks about the restrictions like law and order. But what is shocking here, Rahul, is that you will claim that a film will lead to a law and order problem, but people will protest and claim to violate the law with impunity, like beheading people. That is what, the cure is worse than the disease in that case.
Okay, so let me ask you, is this a cheap publicity stunt? Vikram Pratap Singh, big stunt. Cheap publicity stunt.
This is the cheap publicity stunt done by Mr. Bhansali. This is a total propaganda.
Have you seen the movie?
Which is running since from 1.5 years.
Have you seen the movie?
Say, we are the one who have initiated the process of dialogue.
Have you seen the movie?
We have initiated the web started the process of dialogue with that guy.
What does the censor board exist for then?
The bodyguards of Mr. Bansal.
What does the censor board exist if everybody is going to take the law into their own hands? Everybody is going to be a self-styled center. Why have a censor board in this country?
Have you seen the movie?
Why have a censor board?
Have you seen the film? Has anyone here seen the film?
Expression? Why do we have fundamental rights? Why do we have courts? Why do we have the constitution? Why do we have the law?
If
everybody is going to take the law into their own hands and threaten violence, then this every film is such a
fundamental question.
Any problem?
Fundamental question. Mr. Singh, let me ask you a fundamental question tonight. I want to pull out the pictures of Sanjay Leela Bhansali being attacked in January. We're going to play those pictures. You can see those pictures, January 27th, one day after Republic Day. Was the film ready then? It was still being shot. Was the trailer ready then? No. But you beat up this man. Did you read the script? No. How did you know whether he was making a movie which was going to upset your sensitivities or not? आपको पहले कैसे खाब में आया? जैसे खिलजी को खाब आया, आपको भी खाब आया? मुझे बताइए, did you dream like Mr. Khilji?
नहीं, मैं बताता हूँ कौन सा ख्वाब आया।
नहीं, I'll tell you.
मैं बताता हूँ।
I'll tell you.
मैं बताता हूँ।
There was a sting that was conducted on you, Mr. Singh and your company.
No, I'll also tell you.
No, let me tell you. There was a sting that was conducted on you and some of your leaders, sir, said that they would take money and disrupt. And they would do it quite regularly. So not only was this a publicity stunt, but this was a lucrative deal. That is what the accusation was. I'm not making the accusation. Now you tell me, sir, how did you know before the film was ready, film's shooting was over, that it was going to upset
that
you?
Did you read? Just like same fiction which Mr. Bansali is making.
आपने वो विजुअल नहीं देखे?
That was also a matter of fiction.
Let's show those real visuals to him. January 27th, Mr. Bansali being beaten, you people came on this channel and you defended your actions. How did you know that the film was going to offend your sensitivities before it was even ready? मुझे ये जवाब दीजिए आप.
मैं आपको जवाब देता हूँ इसी बात का. Let me speak.
Yeah, go ahead. Tell us. Tell us.
जब ये मूवी बन रही थी जब when पद्मावती इज वॉज इन मेकिंग जस्ट बिफोर 10 or 15 डेज आई डोंट नो what इज द एग्जैक्ट डेट द आर्टिस्ट द पर्सन हु आई डोंट नो his नेम पर्सन इज प्लेइंग द रोल ऑफ मिस्टर खिलजी आई थिंक रणवीर सिंह ही इज रणवीर सिंह ट्वीटेड दैट इफ देर इज नो इंटीमेट सीक्वेंस आई वुड हैव बीन नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस फिल्म वॉट इज दिस Can't you show some sort of courtesy towards the sensitive topics? Towards the topics which are important for public, which are important for public in those
Mr.
things
Vikram
which public
Pratap
shows
Singh,
strength. You come to
what
Rajasthan
was the context?
And we treat Padmavati as
no, what was the
Please
context?
That is the job of the censor.
What was the subtext? That's not your job. It's the job of the censor to see.
The board will decide that.
You can make a representation to the censor board. You don't have to make a representation to Bansali and threaten him with death. Now, let me bring in Vaibhav Agarwal. Vaibhav Agarwal, I'm asking you a very
How
simple question.
How many historians are there in that censor board?
January 27th.
That is a separate question.
January 27th, the attack on Bansali. Do you legitimize that attack? Do you say it was okay? It should happen again? This
no,
time with a machete?
I condemn it. I denounce it. It should not happen again.
Then let me ask you.
On record.
When three people are saying on live television that it will happen again, that a beheading will
not
take place
action,
again.
Would it amount to abetment?
That, yes, exactly. That's the question I was about to ask you. And you do nothing about it. Will you be an abettor in an act of supreme criminality? I'm asking you, yes, no. Yes, no.
No.
Why?
We will not.
Why?
No. And can I get 30 seconds now?
Please.
I would just like to
because before doing
throw
so,
some
Mr.
light
Bansali
here.
Should also be arrested.
I would like to ask Sanjay Leela Bansali and hear me patiently and I'm going to add some value here. My two pennies, please. So Sanjay Leela Bhansali continuously says that it is a poet's story and the narrative created by some guy called Mohammad Ilyasi, you know, which is after 237 years of the entire story. So 1303 is when the story happened, and then 237 years later, I'm poor at math, so no worries. But you know, 200 years later, there's a poet that writes in, and it's a Muslim poet. I would like to ask the filmmakers, why was, and I'm going to read this to you, and I'm going to read this to you. Dhorata hoon suno rakt se likhi hui kurbani. जिसके कारण मिट्टी भी चंदन है राजस्थानी रावल रतन सिंह के छल से कैद किया खिलजी ने काल गई मित्रों से मिलकर दाग किया खिलजी ने खिलजी को चित्तौड़ के दुर्ग में एक संदेश आया जिसको सुंदर शक्ति सौर्य फिर अंधेरा छाया 10 दिन के भीतर ना पद्मनी को डाला को डोला यदि आया यदि ना रूप की रानी को तुमने दिल्ली पहुंचाया This is the narrative created by Pandit Narendra Mishra. Pandit Narendra Mishra is a celebrated Hindi poet. Why
My dear
the
man,
makers of the film consider a Hindi narrative again?
Vaibhav Agarwal. Research
the proper narrative.
Vaibhav Agarwal.
And make the movie. It's a creative work of fiction.
Let me ask
I'm
you.
Working on it. And
Vaibhav
I'm
Agarwal.
To you as a citizen first.
Is your Rajput honor, one second, is it going to get, besmirched by a work of fiction, by empty facts? Do you think that the honor of the great Rani is going to be dented by this absolute moronic and absolutely strange completely fictionalized consequence of events? Do you think it is so brittle?
Then keep it fiction, na? Keep it fiction.
I'm only asking you. 1 minute.
Why you want to have a...
Let the CBFC decide. That's the point. Who are you?
My question is this.
आप कौन होते हैं? इतने आपका खून जलता है, तो आप border पे जाके लड़ाई कीजिए. इतना आपको beheadings, enemies, अगर आपको असली enemies देखने हैं, तो जाइए कश्मीर. वहाँ पर आप मारिए Burhan Wani & Company को. Go kill Burhan Wani & Company.
Once the loss is done, it's done.
I'm asking you.
Once the loss is done, it's done.
Defenseless people you want to behead. I'm asking you.
It is done.
What kind of honor is this? What kind of honor is this?
Yes, we behead those persons also.
Which
that
where?
Rajput community.
Why don't you go?
Ample part
the Karni Sena has so much anger within them, sir. Our national sentiment is desecrated on a daily basis
yes,
on our borders.
Go out there.
Chinese do it. Pakistanis do it. Go to our borders.
That is
go uphold the national sentiment.
For our country.
But let me ask you, 1 minute, let me ask you, sir.
Yes, we are.
Vaibhav Agarwal, you have not answered my question, and I want to bring in Mr. KTS Tulsi right after. Will you become an abettor? Will the state be guilty of abetment
right.
if the same happens to Sanjay Leela Bhansali, only this time he dies? I'm asking you, can you absolve yourself?
I'm absolutely agreeing to what you're saying, and the state will not become an abettor. Ravi Shankar Prasad, who's the Minister for Justice, has already made a statement 20 minutes back saying that we will not let anything happen like this, and the center has already stepped in from a government perspective.
Since you are now giving me gyan about the center, let me tell you the reason a national spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party is not on this debate, and let me be very clear to our viewers, is because the center has not taken a position right now. They are leaving it hopefully to the state, which is how it should be, because state upholds law and order in this country. And your state government, your chief minister is upholding anarchy, sir. And therefore, let me go back to Mr. KTS Tulsi. Mr. KTS Tulsi, I'm only asking you a very simple question tonight. If there is physical and bodily harm to the actor and the director on the back of these threats, I want to ask you, can the state be charged with abetment to whatever crime is committed? Simple question.
I don't know whether the state can be charged, but these persons in whose presence the threat has been made and they have taken no action, because it is a duty of even a citizen to prevent an offense. And what to talk about citizen, even a minister is refusing to take cognizance of the fact that the threats are being made left, right and center in his presence. And if he doesn't do anything, that means he is actually encouraging and aiding the commission of the offense. And he would certainly be liable not only as an abettor, but also as a co-conspirator.
Vaibhav Agarwal, it was the BJP that questioned Mamata Banerjee over a government censorship of Tariq Fatah. Yeah. Why the silence and the hypocrisy now? Why are you silent? Absolutely. People are asking you. People are asking
what,
you.
Whatever we are saying
because
out of anger.
There is no silence.
Who is the abettor
for no
it?
Silence.
Who is
where the is the arrest?
Mamata Banerjee
why
government.
Why isn't this man
desecrating people
let me
for
ask
political
you.
Reasons?
Let me ask you, sir.
And that is that has
are you not a,
there
are you not
already
a,
there.
No, I'm asking you. Are you not therefore guilty of abetment and giving a free hand and the license for these Karni Senas, etc. to take matters into their own hand? You've heard an expert opinion on this.
Look, I would like to add on to the expert and to the expert's opinion here and for the enlightenment of everyone on the panel. If I, Rahul, if I was to sign your signatures on a piece of paper, fold the paper and keep it in my pocket, and until I use that paper, it won't be breaking any law. So until and unless the action has been happened, if you're talking only specifically law, I'm in KTS.
So I'm talking specific
law. Mr.
Pinto.
He's a senior.
Mr. Pinto, neither has Mr. Bhansali's movie been released. So he has not committed any crime. He has not at this moment in time upset anyone's sentiments. The movie is not out there. Number two, the only people who are breaking the law are the Karni Sena,
in fact,
who are making these murderous, chilling threats. They are the only ones who've broken the law. Bhansali is giving his movie for review to CBFC. We broke that story earlier.
In fact, Sanjay Leela Bhansali should be charged for instigating a mob.
Where?
They are clearly,
what has he done? Has he put out the movie? No.
People are
has he spoken? No. And the only time he has spoken, he has said that you are dreaming about a dream sequence. It doesn't exist. In fact, if anything, he's trying to tell you that you are out of your depth and out of your mind because your paranoia has gripped you.
I can show it to you on the
so what are you talking about?
Camera right now.
What are you talking about?
Let Bhansali come and say.
What are you talking about? Has the movie been screened?
That we are talking about.
Has the movie been publicly screened? Let me bring in Mr. Pinto. Mr. Pinto.
There are tens of trailers that are.
Mr. Pinto, who has broken the law here?
There are
independent. 1 minute. Let me get an independent voice. Who has broken the law? Has Bhansali broken the law? Has he incited?
Clearly,
or is it the Karni Sena? Tell me.
Clearly, the ones who are protesting are prejudging the issue. They haven't seen the film yet. There is a censor board to look into this. There are guidelines. There's a Cinematograph Act. There are guidelines under the CBFC. There are CBFC guidelines. Clearly, they seem to be giving credence to what even the Supreme Court once quoted Oscar Wilde, who said, nothing in this country, nothing succeeds like excess. They are clearly overstepping the mark. They cannot actually, the only obstacle to a film is if there is an imminent breach of peace, threat to breach of peace or law and order. And that also in the Supreme Court in the Rangarajan case that clearly said should not be too far-fetched. There should be a direct nexus. Only if there's a threat to law and order, only in that scenario can a movie, can a film be censored or banned or whatever.
Okay,
in this case, even before it goes in for censorship, there are people jumping the gun and issuing all these kind of
things,
which is completely
Vaibhav Agarwal, there's your response from a legal perspective. KTS Tulsi, do you agree with Mr. Pinto, or do you disagree with him?
Yes,
but can I take people's right away?
No, I entirely agree.
In a democracy,
I entirely agree.
This is not a protest, sir. This is criminal intimidation. It's under the law.
Absolutely.
The protest has turned into criminal intimidation and murderous threats. Excuse me. Some people are saying we're going to walk into someone's house and behead him. Another person is saying we're going to cut off someone's nose. Don't you get it? Or have you completely lost perspective? And the perspective you have lost, Mr. Vaibhav Agarwal, because your politics is blinding you to the infractions of the law.
This is anger. This is anger.
It's a very strange case.
There is a narrative that is there, and I think we should absolutely follow the narrative on the debate. You have an excellent debate.
Now let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, 1 second. I want to end this debate by jogging the BJP's memory back to the comments that were made by a man who represented the Congress party in the 2014 Lok Sabha elections. And he came out and made some vile, murderous statements against the then contender Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the BJP, in short, that person had a criminal case to answer for. That individual is today facing a case. His name is Imran Masood. Same principle should be applied. Sanjay Leela Bhansali today is being accused of breaking the law. Silence is being accused of breaking the law. Murderous statements that are being made by the Senas are being condoned, justified.
Where is he?
Tomorrow, the BJP, which is on the receiving end in Kerala, which is on the receiving end in Bengal, when their cadres are attacked, they should not complain. Because you see, after all, that is freedom of expression. Let's leave it at that.